riding on the city of New Orleans, Illinois Central, Monday morning rail. 15 cars and 15 restless riders.
Stick around for today's video, which is coming up next. Hey everybody, and welcome back to the Denver and Rio Grande Western Iron Horse Route. This is Brian. Today is April 20th, 2019. I wanted to come to you and do a layout tour today. This coming week, I'm going to be doing some changes, some scenery work, making some changes to the layout. Just got some Bettendorf trucks installed. Got a four-car train running. And so I wanted to show the train running around the layout in its present state. As I said, I'm going to have some changes coming up. So I wanted to go ahead and get some good documentation of some trains running with that. And I figured I'd go ahead and post that to you. Again, like I was saying, I just recently installed some Bettendorf trucks. They are the bee's knees. I actually did a two-part series on those. And if you haven't seen those, I'm going to put a card right here so you can check those out if you'd like, as well as on the end screen. I also modeled the line between Denver's Union Station and Winter Park, Colorado, and I did a history or a background on that line, and I did that a few weeks ago. That was a three-part series, and if you haven't seen that, go ahead and check that out right here. I also put a card in the end screen for that as well. As I said, today, I'm just going to be doing a layout tour, shooting it through to you. As I mentioned, I recently installed some trucks, and I had five cars trying to get around, and I kind of ran my loco a little hard. And I noticed that something's going on with it that wasn't going on before. It seems like I've lost a little bit of draw bar pull. Not a bunch, just a little bit. And again, there's something going on with it that didn't previously happen. And so I'm going to kind of sneak that in here at the beginning of the video. I'm going to reach out for a little help. Anybody who can maybe send me a response, a comment, and let me know what you think the problem could be. I've already spoke with Claude. I appreciate your what you said, and that I'm looking into that, but I'm also going to reach out and just see what everybody else has. It's not the traction tires, Claude. That's going to come to you as well right here at the beginning of the video. Before I get the trains rolling, I'm going to show you what's going on with that. And that's enough talk out of me. Let's go ahead and get some trains running. All right, the loco is on the track, and I'm zoomed in so you can see it. So you won't be able to see me, and that's probably something that you prefer, right? I mean, it's probably better. Anyway, what's going on is normally, this is how I normally, where I normally load the cars. And yes, it's on a grade. It's somewhere between 7% and 8% downhill, and I'm going to be adding four cars. And what's happening is, as I start to add the cars, the loco is freewheeling some downhill, which did not previously happen. And since that started, I have noticed a slight, very slight difference in the amount of drawbar pull, in the fact that I have lost a little bit. And so I'm going to put this together right now for you as quickly as possible. See, that never happened previously. I'm going to go ahead and finish loading them, but you've seen now what I wanted you to see. That one, I need to change that out. Actually, that is the first Bettendorf coupler that I've gotten in those sets that has a slight a coupler that's slightly opened up slightly too much. Not quite uniform with all the others, and I'm going to have to change that. It's actually, as long as it's on the back, it's not a problem, but you see this? You see how that's inching and creeping down? That was not previously happening, and I'm assuming what happened is I ran the loco too hard and I've done something, and I need to know if it's something that I need to fix or whatever. So if you guys can help with that, boy, I sure would appreciate it. going to actually run the trains now and do a layout tour for you, and be back with you at the end. Thanks. If you can help, I sure would appreciate you leaving a comment, sharing to anybody you think in the field that might be able to help. Sure would appreciate that. Thanks, guys.
Yeah, you see that right there? That was not previously occurring at that level. Now, I'm going to inch it up. Now, probably at this next speed setting, it will be fine. Now, also, it seemed like I had a little bit of a break or something almost there before that I don't seem to have now. It's like it's renewing.
You know, I get what I mean.
Now, the thing is, see, I'm going to be able to show you a video if that wasn't happening.
Alright, and as you'll be able to see in the next video, these problems weren't previously occurring. I added the fifth car, actually a problematic car, and I put some strain on the loco, and I think that's the problem. What I would love to know from you guys, though, is from your expertise, how you think I should proceed, maybe what you think it is, what you think, what action you think I should take, and how you think I should proceed if you are in my situation. Thanks, guys. I appreciate you.
Riding on the city of New Orleans, Illinois Central, Monday morning rail. 15 cars and 15 restless riders, 3 conductors and 25 sacks on mail. All along the southbound Odyssey, out at Kankakee and rolls along past houses, farms, and fields. Passing trains that have no name and freight yards full of old black men and the graveyards of the rusted automobile. Good morning, America, how are you? Ain't no one keeping score. Pass the paper bag that holds the bottle. Feel the wheels rumbling beneath the floor. And the sons of Pullman porters and the sons of engineers ride their father's magic carpet made of steel.
As always, I'd like to thank you for stopping in and hanging out today. I sure would appreciate it if you're able to leave a comment and help me with that problem I got with my loco. If you have not already, please subscribe. Click the bell icon so you can be alerted to future uploads, because Wednesday I got an upload coming on homemade terminal rail joiners, how you can save yourself a few dollars. I'm going to have links on the end screen to the history I told you about earlier, as well as the two-part series on the Bettendorf trucks. This is Brian from the Denver and Rio Grande Western Iron Horse Route, signing off.
Rocky Mountain High.